Hello my dear friends, in this short video, I am going to deal with the question or the topic, where did Jesus say, I am God and worship me? Before I go ahead and answer this question, I would like to show you a small clip.
Brothers, sisters, I would like you to do me a favor. If Jesus is God, I would like you to show me one verse, only one statement anywhere in your Bible, any version of the Bible where Jesus says, I am God, or where he says, worship me.
I am asking you.
Yes.
Do you agree?
Yeah.
Do you believe that Jesus is God?
Yes.
Yes, brother.
Now, either you get true peace or I will come to your peace. Yes. Correct? If you are this true peace, I will leave my peace and I will join you.
Yes.
Now you told me Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is God. I challenge you to point out a single verse in the Bible, a single unequivocal verse from the Bible, a single unambiguous verse in which Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me and I am ready to accept Christianity.
Muslims all over the world have been trained by Islamic preachers like Ahmad Didat and Zakir Naik to ask Christians the same question in exact words. Where did Jesus say, I am God and worship me? Even before any Christian starts to answer their question, they will stop you and say, no, show me from Bible. Where did Jesus say in exact words, I am God, worship me? Now, I would like to ask my Muslim friends a question. Can you show me from Quran, where did Jesus say, I am not God, do not worship me? I repeat, show me in Quran, in exact words, where did Jesus say, I am not God and do not worship me? I think it's a silly criteria asking for exact words. I could frame so many questions using exact words criteria. But rather, I would like to show you through this short video in a reasonable way. Where did Jesus really claim to be God and accepted worship? I am going to use both Quran as well as Bible to answer this question. One of the 99 names of Allah, according to Quran chapter 57 verse 3, is the first and the last. Al-Awwal means the first, Al-Akhir means the last. Now, let us go to the Old Testament of the Bible from Isaiah chapter 44 verse 6. This is what the Lord says, Israel's King and Redeemer, the Lord Almighty, I am the first and the last. Apart from me, there is no God. If we see both the verses, both Quran and the Old Testament agrees that God is the first and the last. If anyone who says that he is the first and the last, he is definitely claiming to be God. Now, let us go to the New Testament of the Bible from Book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 17. It says, when I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead. Then he placed his right hand on me and said, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead and now I am alive forever and ever. And I hold the keys of Hades and death. If you observe this verse, Jesus Christ is a speaker. And he is saying that he is the first and the last. So Jesus Christ is claiming to be God. Now, one of the 99 names of Allah, according to Quran, Surah chapter 22, verse 6, is Al-Haq, the truth. Now, let us go to the New Testament of the Bible, from Book of John, chapter 14, verse 6. It says, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you observe these two verses, Jesus Christ says he is the truth. That means he is claiming to be God. Again, One of the 99 names of Allah, according to Quran, is Al-Ghafar, which means the great forgiver. If you see Psalms chapter 103 and verse 3, Yahweh is the one who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases. Now, let us go to the New Testament of the Bible from Gospel of Mark chapter 2 verses 8 to 12. At once, Jesus knew in his spirit that they were considering this within themselves. "Why do you question these things in your hearts?" he asked. "Which is easier to say to a paralyzed man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, pick up your mat and walk'? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "I tell you, get up, pick up your mat and go home." And immediately the man got up, picked up his mat and walked out in front of them all. As a result, everyone was amazed and glorified God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." Now, if you see again, the audience here are the Jewish people. They exactly know what Jesus is doing. Jesus is claiming to be God and doing things only God can do. He heals the person and he also forgives him. In this case, again, Jesus claims to be God. Now let us see Exodus chapter 20 verse 10. "But the seventh day is a Sabbath day of rest, dedicated to the Lord your God." Now let us go to Mark chapter 2 verses 28. It says, "So the Son of Man is Lord even over the Sabbath." If you observe both the verses, according to Exodus chapter 20 verse 10, Yahweh is a Lord of Sabbath. But in Mark chapter 2, Jesus claims to be the Yahweh of the Old Testament. And it is very clear that Jesus again claimed to be God. Now, let us see from Matthew chapter 26, verses 62 to 65. "Then the high priest stood up and said to Jesus, 'Are you not going to answer? What is this testimony that these men are bringing against you?' But Jesus remained silent. The high priest said to him, 'I charge you under oath by the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God.' 'You have said so,' Jesus replied. 'But I say to all of you, from now on, you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven.' Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, 'He has spoken blasphemy. Why do we need any more witnesses? Look, now you have heard the blasphemy.'" If you observe these verses, Jesus makes three divine claims. One is the Messiah, the Son of God, and the Son of Man. When Jesus said that he is the Messiah, he knows that the Jews would understand his divine claim. Now, if you come to Bible, Isaiah chapter 61 verse 1. "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners." So according to this verse, Messiah means the anointed one. He is anointed to save. He is the savior who saves his people from their sins. So my dear friends, if we observe all these points, it is very clear that Jesus Christ is claiming to be the promised Messiah, the anointed one who is going to save his people from their sins. Now, let us see the term the Son of God. When the high priest asked Jesus, "Are you the Son of God?" Jesus said, "Yes, I am." If you see the term the Son of God, it's a definite article. It means one and only one. Remember that there are many sons of God. David was a son of God. Israelites were sons of God. I am a son of God, but Jesus is the Son of God. He is separate from all sons of God. When Jesus said that He is the Son of God, He not only inherits what all His Father have, but He also inherits His divinity, His divine nature to be God. So Jesus claimed to be God by saying that He is the Son of God. Jesus not only claims to be the Messiah and the Son of God, but He also claims to be the Son of Man. Jesus says that you will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of the heaven. Now, when Jesus said that He is the Son of Man, every Jew in the audience know this divine claim. They know that Jesus is claiming to be the Son of Man of Daniel chapter 7 verses 13 and 14. In my vision at night, I looked and there before me was one like a Son of Man, coming with the clouds of heaven. He approached the Ancient of Days and was led into His presence. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. All nations and peoples of every language worshipped Him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that will not pass away, and His kingdom is one that will never be destroyed. When Jesus made this claim, the high priest tore his clothes in horror and said that this man has blasphemed. That means this man is claiming to be God. So my dear friends, if you observe these verses from Matthew chapter 26, we can clearly say that Jesus claimed to be the Messiah, the Son of God, and the Son of Man. Three divine claims. Now, let us see where did Jesus really accepted worship when people came to worship Him. The wise men worshipped Him from the moment He was born, in Matthew chapter 2. The leper worshipped Him at His healing, in Matthew chapter 8. The synagogue ruler worshipped Him, in Matthew chapter 9. The disciples worshipped Him on the boat, in Matthew chapter 14. The Canaanite woman worshipped Him in Matthew chapter 15. The blind man worshipped Him at His healing in John chapter 9. The woman worshipped Him at empty tomb in Matthew chapter 28. Jesus always claimed to be God, and He also demonstrated the power and authority that belongs to God alone. Before I conclude, I want to tell to my Muslim friends, don't let a silly criteria asking for exact words stop you from knowing the reality about Jesus Christ, His divine nature. He is the Son of God and He is God. I also wanted to say to my Muslim friends that Jesus Christ is not just a prophet or just a messenger, but He is more than that. He is the Son of God and He is God. If you can understand His divine nature, you can have eternal life in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is God forever and ever. So my dear friends, if you like this video, please do share it with your friends. And also please do subscribe to my YouTube channel, Suman Kumar Polepaka. Know the truth and the truth will set you free. God bless you.